Ran for this position again, and this was what was contained in a letter that was directed to the president and Labour CS, saying that, you know what, we cannot have this guy again because he was deregistered, and of course making him not capable to be Sec General again.
I thought once a teacher, always a teacher.
I guess you can always lose your license, like in medicine.
But remember, there was that issue last year. On Sosion again, by the way.
All right. And I think at that point, we just want to take a very quick break. We'll be right back with more of these stories. It is the main story that is on the front page of the Daily Nation. Mm-hmm. Of course, the other stories have been touched on the different dailies when it comes to the reaffirmation of Biden's win, Ruto, and why he's not going to change his mind on BBI, as well as what happened in Msambweni. So stay with us. We'll be right back after this quick breather.
Good morning.
Moka
ni yako
hii nduti ni yangu niliwahi pale Quickbit Quickbit imekuja kusaidia wananchi kama sisi ndio nilinunua 399 shillings juu nilikuwa the lowest unique bidder
399 shillings
Quickbit shilingi moja unaweza nunua shilingi mbili unaweza nunua micro shilingi tano unaweza nunua hata gari
sio tupeleke huko hata
mtu aende huko
Jiunga na QuickBit ni rahisi. Enda kwenye M-Pesa, bonyeza paybill kisha weka business number 4032353. Kwenye account, weka kodi ya bidhaa unayotaka na bidii yako ya chini zaidi. Kwa mfano, TV 16. Kisha weka shilingi 20 tu kama idadi yako. Weka bidii yako pia kwenye www.quickbit.co.ke. Kumbuka, bidii ya chini zaidi ya kipekee ndio ununua. QuickBit, bidhaa bora kwa bei ya chini.
Tonight on KBC Channel 1.
We have to run from here. Both of you go in that direction. Banti, Budeshwar and I shall go in the opposite direction.
Come on, move.
That boy will be sacrificed. And my dear brother will be hailed.
In order to lay a foundation of one's rule, if so many innocent people have been killed, then what is the point of such a ruler? And for how long will this series of murders and tortures go on?
Tonight on KBC Channel 1.
Where's your Mimi?
It is all over, Cobra. Good work. Arrest this bugger.
Who is this? Hello? Can I help you? Who is this?
I needed more time with him. More time.
Although this doesn't make it better, we are here for you. I am here for you. You will always be my son. You know that.
Tonight on KBC Channel 1.
So are you gonna pay attention to me now? We have to get out of here,
Mother,
okay?
That is something that we can't do.
What do you mean we can't do that? You promised me.
I don't think there was ever a bride who's as much in love as me. And I'm the happiest woman in the world to see my... I can call you my daughter, right?
I don't even know why you have to ask.
Oh, honey.
I now pronounce you husband and wife. What God has put together, let no man put asunder.
Juntos el paraíso conocimos. El paraíso conocimos.
In love with Ramon. Two lionesses struggle to cohabit.
Because I'm not gonna stand here and be compared to some...
Hey, Nancy, don't try me.
as the coastal vacation brings Nancy and Joe closer.
Nancy, you are full of surprises. What would you like me to do for you this morning?
Or will it be?
Now, can you give us some space?
No. He? Ronaldi? Ni usherati? Watch your mouth, Mother Teresa.
Or what?
This game is that you and Nancy are playing.
Na nyinyi mmekuwa akina nani kuingilia mambo ya wazazi wenu.
Stringed, making a comeback. Hota.
Just gonna stand there and stare at us?
How do you think things will end up here?
This is a conversation between your father and I.
Sometimes it would be good if you would just stand your ground.
Wait, Mtoto, wait. What happens between me and Mama Paul is none of your business.
Boulder.
You know Mama Paul is leaving you.
So what?
What?
I'm done being your puppet and dancing to your tune and manipulation.
I called the clients and told them that your purchase status is down.
Only on KBC Channel 1. Fridays at 8:30 p.m.
That is such a beautiful day. Welcome back to the program. In case you are just joining us, good morning.
Mm-hmm.
Welcome. This is Good Morning Kenya. I am Jane Mamboy. He is Sam Jarogen, that beautiful lady on the extreme. And she is Doreen Arange.
I tell you.
And you are right in time for In the Headlines. This is just a segment that we get to have a quick look at the different dailies this morning. I have a copy of the Daily Nation, and I will start us off with the main story in regards to the mighty fall of Soussion. As there's this internal rebellion that is brewing in the union because some 90 out of 110 branches want this long-serving boss out. Soussion has been the Secretary General of the Kenya National Union of Teachers, and he was hoping for a re-election come next year when they have the elections, but at least 90 out of the 110 branch secretaries say that he needs to be blocked from vying again for this position because why? They argue that he is not eligible since he was deregistered as a teacher, and this was indicated on a letter that the officials had addressed to the president, Mr. Kenyatta, and of course Labour CS on the 15th of December, pointing out this key factor which has made him has made his viability null and void. So you can get to read more of that and what they are saying in regards to blocking Soussion from running again as the Secretary General of the Union.
As the SG of the Union.
Yes, sir.
I don't know whether ladies have ever gone through something called colorism.
I haven't.
Never ever? Doreen?
At least consciously, maybe I might have missed it.
Ikakupita tu. So colorism is where you actually feel out of place because of your skin tone. And you're literally made to feel like you don't belong. Okay? Mm-hmm. And that is why page 3 of the Standard is focusing on this particular issue, colorism, especially in Africa, because it is here with us. And the question now begs, is black still as beautiful? Bias against dark skin is here with us. And we've seen people attempt to bleach, people attempt to change their skin tone, others going way to the extreme of getting plastic surgery. And that is the story now here.
But that is such a reality in the U.S.
It is.
Especially light-skinned blacks and dark-skinned, dark-skin-toned black Americans.
I was having a friend who was narrating to me how the situation is in Hollywood in as far as colorism is concerned. And it is real, by the way. It is so real. There are places you just feel not accepted because of the color of your skin. And at times, you feel this narrative of, we need to promote black culture. It's like...
And then again, it's broken down to what is black, how black is black.
And then it's broken down now. That is the most offending part. Offensive
part. Like what exactly is black?
Like what exactly is black? Others even have gone a notch higher to try and have black fantasies.
Mm-hmm.
if you know what I mean.
Mm-hmm.
And this has nothing to do with what you're thinking, all of y'all. It's mm-hmm. just like, how would Black react mm-hmm. if it is subjected to this situation? So Black has become like a guinea pig of sorts mm-hmm. for trial and error. And that has become now a concern. And that is the story that has been highlighted, talking about evidence in Asia and Africa, as well as the US and Latin America, originating from the days of slavery. And you know, even right here in the country, there are places where an African or a Black person cannot rent a house.
Oh, yes.
Panzai Parklands, Ikwapa.
Exactly.
The bougie.
No, we just need to be truthful. Cindy,
yeah,
these things are happening. Mm. Like,
Afadhali. As you're mentioning those specific places, even, actually, I remember there was a time we were even having a convo with a friend. And you see, it brings us thinking of, you are in your own country.
Yes.
You are a Black in that country. So you'd wonder why it becomes so difficult for you to even stay there.
Afadhali, iyo hao ikai empty. Lakini usikodishe. Uwezi ingia. And these are the realities that we're dealing with. So I just thought of throwing that in the as a spanner in the works. Because when you think about colorism and racism, at times we think from a macro point of view, but quite literally is here with us in the country.
The devil is in the details.
Yeah, there are places in Westlands, there are places in Parklands. Uwezi kodisha nyumba if you're Black.
Even this Kilimani area.
Afadhali iyo hao ikae bila mtu. Lakini sipewe a Black person.
Even when you're talking, when we are talking about bleaching, sometimes this is what even brings people to want to do that, because they feel less accepted. They feel I have to look a certain way for me to be accepted, or I have to look a certain way and be a certain way for me to live in a certain place.
Yeah.
I don't know, guys, if you remember, there was a while back, there was this viral video of this young girl. She was, I think, on Dr. Phil. She was a Black girl, and she was convinced that she is white.
Yeah, was it Dr. Phil or Steve Harvey?
One of the two. I'm not sure, but it was one of the two.
It was Steve Harvey.
Yeah, Steve Harvey.
She was convinced that she was white.
And she is Black.
She even said, you know, I don't like associating with Black people because they do not behave like we, the white people who are superior. Ooh.
It's sad. So page 4 to 5 of the Star today also highlights issues to do with the Nairobi Mogadishu spot or row, diplomatically speaking. And Kenya-Somalia diplomatic row now triggers fears of terror attacks. Remember, we saw the U.S. sometime early this month withdraw their troops from Somalia, saying that it's no longer a going concern for them. And now, in the wake of this particular row, what does it mean for our territorial borders? What does it mean for security? What does it mean when it comes to the war against terror? Those are some of the issues that have been expressed in as far as this particular spot is concerned, covered in earnest pages 4 to 5 of the Star today. As I hand it over to Doreen, when I return, I'll be telling you why Sonko has lost a bid to stop ouster debate today. And also on page 7 of the Star, I'll be telling you how Governor of Nyamira, that is John Nyagarama, is faring. He's on life support at the Nairobi Hospital, and we'll be giving you more details in as far as his battle with COVID-19 is concerned. Doreen?
All right, now I want to come to the issue of the nurses strike, as well as the clinician strike. Now, this also comes at a time when, remember, the doctors through the KNPDU mentioned that if all what they've been asking for and complaining about are not met by 21st of this month, then they will go on strike, which only means it will be next week on Monday. So how has the situation been thus far, given the fact that the strike enters day 10, and this is the strike for the clinicians and the nurses? Now, nurses' strike continues as effects of unrest bite. And this is as the nurses and clinicians strike enters its 10th day. Kenyans seeking medical services have been left with a dwindling hope for a return to normalcy in the health sector, with the industrial action urging a number of residents and leaders. Calls to have the healthcare workers back to work has proven futile. Now, a number of government hospitals, especially here in the country, have now completely shut down, with those operating without nurses and and clinicians. And now this nurses on strike, the nurses, and just as I mentioned, it has now entered day 10. The Kenya National Union of Nurses in Mombasa branch has now also asked all its members to vacate their workstations within 12 hours. In Narok, people living along the Kenya-Tanzania border have been forced to seek medical attention in the neighboring country. Now again, as I mentioned, all their pleas have not been heard. And just what the nurses, the doctors, the clinicians have been mentioning is that they're saying they're not even asking for too much. They just want protective equipment and, you know, all their pleas to be heard. And this is in regards to insurance, their pays to come in on time, as well as their allowances. So we're still waiting to see what the government will do, even as we wait to see whether or not the doctors will go on strike on 21st, as they had mentioned, if at all their cries and pleas and complaints are not heard by that day.
All right. You can also, that story about the medics has also been highlighted here on the back page of the Daily Nation, with SRC saying that we are not going to give you any pay rises because it is not affordable at the moment. And yeah. And also looking at that risk allowance of 30K that they wanted. You can read more of what has been highlighted on the Daily Nation in regards to that particular story, as well as the role when it comes to the Kenya-Somali ties. Here they've titled it Drums of War. So dramatic. As Kenya insists.
That's the Daily Nation.
Yes,
it's
drums
just a
of
row.
War. I know. But they go on to say that Kenya insists that it will not retaliate but seek to restore diplomatic ties.
It's important, by the way, that we restore those ties, because in the short term, Kenya stands to lose.
Yes. And
in the short term, Kenya stands to lose. And it is important that we restore sanity, especially along our borders. Remember the reason why we went into Somalia? You remember that whole hijacking thing of ships, the pirates and everything? You remember that during Kibaki's reign?
Yes.
And it became important that we have a presence in Somalia to restore stability in that particular country. An initiative that was backed by the African Union, an initiative that was backed by countries like the UK and the US. We've seen active conversations happen around AMISOM, especially within the African Union. Right here in the country, there are those who feel, by the way, time has come for us to withdraw our troops from Somalia.
Yeah.
And just early this month, we saw the US withdraw its troops from Somalia, saying it's no longer a going concern for them. But remember, transition is a reality in the US. Mm-hmm. Maybe Biden could be of a different diplomatic view.
Yeah.
And we shall wait on that as soon as he's inaugurated as president on January 20th. So those are some of the intrigues that are coming up. And as far as the row, it's not drums of war.
I know.
It's just a row between Mogadishu and Nairobi.
But there's a resident. All dramatic.
Yeah.
You know, all dramatic.
There's a resident from Mandera town who said that they have woken up to see military officers from Somali taking positions along the border, and this is worrying them a lot. So we do hope that this diplomatic ties are restored, because I mean, war is not something that we would want any degree of it.
Yeah.
So diplomacy is always the best way to go. You can read more of that story here, get to hear some resident accounts of what happened, what they are seeing there, and what they hope will be done. Now, coming to this particular story in regards to the hearing of Nairobi Governor Mike Sonko's impeachment, it will be happening between today and tomorrow. These are the dates that were chosen by Speaker Kenneth after it was rescheduled from last week. And it's going to be happening between today and tomorrow, as the Senate is going to investigate the proposed removal of Mike Sonko from office by impeachment. He was impeached on the 3rd of December. So you can get to read how so far the progress that has been made by the legislators and what they are hoping to do between today and tomorrow before the final vote is put in tomorrow, and we get to know if Nairobi Governor Mike Sonko is going to be deseated as the county governor or he's going to survive this impeachment.
Mm-hmm. Ladies, are you a fan of Screen Rant?
Screen Rant?
Yeah. It's an online platform that usually reviews series and movies and all that. No, you're not familiar with it?
You can tell us more.
I'm going to upgrade the two of you, because right now...
Bojack Dogo.
Oh, goodness.
Okay,
fine.
Upgrade us now.
All right. Yeah, so they're talking about Game of Thrones. You know how passionate I am about Game of Thrones, right?
Doreen.
Yeah.
It's coffee on your behalf. Please do.
It's all about Game of Thrones, and You know what they call the Battle of the Bastards?
Mm.
Yeah. There's a very interesting review about how that particular... Yes?
Oh, I thought you were going to say there's a, like a spin-off that is going to come.
No, no, no. I've been waiting for one, though. Who doesn't want a spin-off from Game of Thrones? Okay.
Anyway, there was this spin-off of the original from Vampire Diaries.
I tell you. Abu, let's continue reviewing the dailies. Because now I'm adoring to a cop.
I shall sip coffee on my behalf.
You know, I like
and I levitate. We got you, baby girl.
We got you. We got you, our dear last one.
I know, you guys are awesome.
Yeah. So now, as Jane was saying, Sonko has lost the bid to stop ouster debate today. He had run to court to try and stop it. And the court now to issue substantive ruling at 3 p.m., but the matter will have to be discussed in the Senate. And we shall be following the proceedings right here at KBC Channel 1 and give you the details as they come. Remember, there was that proposal to have a committee... Okay, look into the validity of his impeachment, but that did not exactly see the light of day, and he will now face a committee of the entire House. That story is developing between today and tomorrow, and we shall be capturing every punchline, every soundbite that will be coming forth from the Senate in as far as the impeachment of Mike Mbuvi Sonko is concerned. Let's also tell you what's happening on page 7 of the Star. John Nyagarama, County Governor of Nyamira, is in Nairobi Hospital. He is on life support, courtesy of COVID-19. That story has been highlighted on page 7 of the Star today. And sources at the hospital said that Nyagarama was put on life support on Sunday night, and his family was called in on Monday after his condition deteriorated. And Nyagarama was taken to the hospital 3 weeks ago when he tested positive for coronavirus. He was admitted to the COVID-19 ICU as he required a lot of oxygen. That is what the paper reports. And he was a patient on increased oxygen demand. He stayed in the COVID-19 ICU under the care of doctors and nurses who are dealing with coronavirus cases. And after 21 days of being managed by medics, the final test was done on him last week. It came out negative. However, doctors recommended that Nyagarama be transferred to the normal ICU to proceed with close medical monitoring as his lungs had suffered multiple failure. And that is the thing about COVID-19, especially at its severe levels. You may test negative at some point, but the damage it has wreaked on your internal organs is devastating. Others now are reporting cases of blood clots after having recovered from COVID-19. So they are put on blood thinners, and of course that affects the quality of life, okay? And that is why it is important to sanitize, put on a mask, observe social distance, and you know, do what you can to contribute towards containing the spread of COVID-19 in the country. The concern may not predominantly lie with coronavirus, but with the effects it leaves you with.
Mm-hmm.
Because right now, he tested negative, yes, but his lungs are damaged. And that is why he is in a critical demand for oxygen. That is what the paper reports, that he has to literally rely on oxygen and a lot of it to survive, because his lungs, zilingia maji and all that. So that story is on page 7 of the Star this morning.
Yeah, and that's why when you keep talking about, you know, just adhering to all these rules and protocols that have been given, just do your part.
Exactly.
If you have to wear, if you're in public, you need to wear the mask, wear. If you have to sanitize all the time, wash your hands, just do the right thing. Now, still keeping up with matters COVID-19, now this is in regards to schools and the dilemma that school heads are now in, given the fact that it is now just 2 weeks before schools reopen, and this is fully reopened on January 4th, where now with only 2 weeks left before schools reopen, teachers and parents are at a loss on how they would enforce the social distancing rule amid a deafening silence from the education ministry, whereby they're saying that there's not really much of what the education ministry is saying in regards to how they're going to ensure that this happens, given the fact that most schools really are grappling with the issue of overcrowding. And actually, they've just mentioned most of the national schools here in the country with huge populations, a key among them, Pangani Girls, Maseno, Maranda, Kenya High, amongst other national schools. And probably what the head teachers as well as parents would like the Ministry of Education to address is how they can be able to deal with it. They had to deal with this issue of social distancing because it is part of those measures or protocols that have been put in place, saying that they are too silent in regards to this issue. So what next, even as we wait for schools to reopen? Yes, there were some funds that have been released, but schools have not yet gotten these funds. So again, this is why it's coming to teachers as well as parents, because again, not every parent can be able to afford this face mask that, you know, the students and children need to go with to school. But again, this is one of those stories that you really just keeping a close eye on, because just as I mentioned, it's only 2 weeks before schools reopen. What next for students? What next for parents? What next for this school heads? We'll still continue with more of what is on the, in the headlines after this short break.
Ni mimi.
Ulitoa vipi kipiki?
Mlitani sitaomoka.
Ni yako.
Hii nduti ni yangu. Hey. Niliwahi pale Quickbit.
Quickbit?
Quickbit imekuja kusaidia wananchi kama sisi. Ndio. Yeah. Nilinunua 399 shillings juu nilikuwa the lowest unique bidder.
99 shillings.
Quickbit shilingi moja unaweza nunua. Shilingi mbili unaweza nunua micro. Shilingi tano unaweza nunua hata gari.
Sio tupeleke huko hata.
Mtu aende huko.
Jiunga na Quickbit ni rahisi. Enda kwenye M-Pesa, bonyeza paybill kisha weka business number 4032353. Kwenye account weka kodi ya bidhaa unayotaka na bidii yako ya chini zaidi. Kwa mfano TV 16. Kisha weka shilingi 20 tu kama idadi yako. Weka bidii yako pia kwenye www.quickbit.co.ke. Kumbuka, bidii ya chini zaidi ya kipekee ndio ununua. Quickbit, bidhaa bora kwa bei ya chini.
A love from the past will mark the love from today.
I love you, Mauro. I love you like I have never loved before.
Now the same obsession that ruined the past will try to destroy the present. Only this time, love will have more than one obstacle ahead.
I need a doctor to tend to her right away. Please, miss. A doctor. Call a doctor.
Loving you is all I want.
Yeah, we were just housekeeping, trying to decide. Unajua hii nyumba lazima tujadiliane, okay?
Yeah.
It's a big happy house, by the way. Good morning, in case you're just joining us. Ken karibu sana. Are you sipping on something, some tea, coffee, some morning beverage? We welcome you to join us as we sip ours right here, as we let you know what is happening with the various dailies right here in the country. We'd like to focus on COVID-19. and critical angles that have been spread across the dailies. We have the first medic or the first Kenyan to receive a jab, that is in Ohio. I highlighted that earlier on in the program. But I'd like to tell you why poor countries face long wait for COVID-19 jabs. Kungoja. It is what it is, because there's a significant level of investment that has gone into developing this particular vaccine, and thus it's first being taken by the people who can afford it. That means
inequality.
No, it doesn't mean inequality, it means equity.
Inequity.
Inequity. Okay? So the poor countries or developing countries will have to wait a little longer for this particular jab. Yes, there are countries that are already rolling out this vaccine, places like the US, the UK, Russia, China. But for us, we'll have to wait a little longer, probably until June next year, at a point where we can actually afford to have it in the country. And that story has been highlighted right there on the eighth page of the Standard today, talking about experts say chances that coronavirus shots will be shared fairly between rich nations and the rest are fading fast, because vitu kwa ground ni different. And of course, the demand varies from country to country, and thus the need of the reality that we could be waiting a little longer to receive this particular vaccine. Now, the total samples that were tested, 978,683, and out of these, 4,878 were tested between Monday and yesterday. This is an update in as far as COVID-19 is concerned. 404 cases right here in the country tested positive yesterday, as we were being briefed by CS Mutahi Kagwe, and the confirmed cases so far are 92,459 right here in the country. Out of the 404, 138 are female, while 266 are male. And why is it that the number of male is usually higher than that of females? So far, we've had 73,979 recoveries, 527 new ones as of yesterday. Total fatalities, courtesy of COVID-19, 1,604 after 11 people died yesterday, courtesy of COVID-19. Also tying in with our particular story from a business angle, the flower farmers now want the tax relief extended, and they said that the sector is still on its knees and needs to recover fully from COVID-19. The plight and plea of flower farms is highlighted there on page 15 of the Star for you this morning. Remember, come January next year, we expect a resumption into normalcy when it comes to things like pay and statutory deductions. But flower farmers are saying, we are not yet ready. You need to cushion us more. And thus, they want the tax relief extended, saying that the sector is still on its knees. That is page 16, page 15 and 16 of the Star for you this morning.
Now, let's get to have a look at the Daily Nation in regards to COVID-19. And there's this piece here that is has been derived from a report that was put out by the Ministry of Health, saying that hospitals lack capacity to fight COVID-19 amid the rising trend that we have been witnessing. Remember, as Regina would say, we are riding the second wave of infections as a country. So, that report indicates that public hospitals in Kenya lack the capacity and personnel to handle the rapidly increasing cases of coronavirus and also sustaining the universal health coverage program. And this is what was included in this report that was tabled at the Senate Health Committee by CES Dr. Masi Mwangangi. This report had assessed about 1,887 hospitals across the country of all levels between September and the 30th of October, and this are some of the deductions that were made from this report. Human resource was the lowest scoring category, especially when it comes to the preparedness of COVID-19. And also looking at the second phase of UHC, human resource was also assessed, and there was only 36% coverage when it comes to the rolling out of the personnel involved in this. Remember from the medic who passed on just the other day, Dr. Mugiso, he was among the 200 that were deployed to Machakos under the universal health coverage to just try and deal with COVID-19 cases in isolation. part of this second phase of the UHC rollout. And according to also the study, level 2 and level 3 hospitals have been performing between 15 and 25% of the required personnel for efficiency for the past 4 to 6 months, which is clearly a 40% undercutting, or rather, when it comes to the expectation that was put forth, 40% below what was required. Now, still keeping up with this particular issues to do with COVID-19, the World Health Organization now says Kenya could be under-reporting COVID-19 deaths. Oh, yes. While the cases and deaths appear to be declining, there could be many fatalities that are not being reported. And this was what the World Health Organization had to say in regards to these fatalities that are being reported in Kenya from hospitals. And it is likely that the cumulative deaths are underreported, according to one of the week's situational reports by World Health Organization. And this is something that is really concerning to the World Health Organization. And also in regards to the story that Doreen had touched about COVID-19 and schools, 17 boys have been isolated after testing positive from Ngumo Secondary in Makueni. So you can read more of that, understand when it comes to the deficiency in capacity of our hospitals to manage these COVID-19 cases. The concern that the World Health Organization is putting forth in regards to the number of cases that Kenya is reporting, as well as the state of schools that have been dealing with COVID-19. Sam.
You call it COVID-19.
Coronavirus.
You don't want to call it coronavirus. Yeah? There's a lot happening, by the way, with the dailies. I'm actually now pushing to see.
They're very thick today.
They're very thick. The papers are quite thick today. And Gideon Moi says that BBI is good for Central Kenya. That story has been covered by the Standard this morning. And leader urges Kenyans to read the document carefully to confirm its gains and support the and supports the initiative. And BBI will support the youth because once Nyeri County gets 13 billion in allocation, 30% will be for youth to deliver goods and services. That is KANU Chair Gideon Moi talking about the BBI as he toured various regions yesterday in a sensitization drive for this particular document. You will find that story on page 12 of the Standard today. Issues to do with the resignation or retiring. Yeah, he retired. He did not resign. He retired. David Maraga as Chief Justice and President of the Judiciary, also covered on page 19 of the Standard this morning. But let me draw your attention to page 23 of the Star. Right? And we've got Young City Ecopreneur among 7 world winners of UNEP Prize. I believe that's a story, yeah? Pocket of sunshine that we need to appreciate. Her name is Nzambi Mate.
Mate?
Okay? Yeah. A Kenyan ecopreneur who is among 7 world winners of this year's United Nations Young Champions of Earth Prize. And Nzambi Mate, who's just 29 years of age, is the founder of Nairobi-based Jenga Makers, a social enterprise that tackles waste pollution, and she collects the waste, mainly plastic bottles, from households and institutions and upcycles it into paving and building blocks. In a press statement that was released, the United Nations Environment Programme said Mate, a materials engineer, emerged winner in Africa. That's a good story on page 23 of the Star for you this morning. Should appreciate Mate.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and that is her name, by the way. I'm not exaggerating.
Mm.
It's Nzambi Mate.
Mundo akwitu.
Mundo akwitu.
Nagwea.
Yeah.
All right, now as we draw to a close of this particular segment, I want to touch on this piece here in regards to, there's this pullout on the Daily Nation. It's called China Watch. And there's this particular piece about submersible crafts that China has been working on to just explore the deepest depths of the waters. And this is happening at the Mariana Trench, which is the deepest, at least what is the deepest known points of the ocean, about 11,000 meters and below sea level. And there's this new submersible craft that students have been working on that is now said to be having broken the record of going to the deepest deep dive known to man so far. They went to approximately 10,999 meters below sea level. And the Mariana Trench is about 11,000 meters. So they were short of about 100 and something meters to get to the deepest point that is known to man. And this is, experts are saying that this opens a new chapter when it comes to deep sea diving and understanding the marine life as a whole, looking at also resources that could be discovered underwater, oil, gold, and other forms of valuable minerals that are being said could potentially be found at these levels. And also looking at marine life that operates at this level, because normally the pressure that is there is not, there's no, not many species are known to survive at those pressures that are around those levels. And this reminds me of this movie, Megalodon.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Come on, Jay, watch, and watch. You'd understand the deep sea life and how it works, the creatures that are there. Some have actually morphed physically to be able to live at such deep, such depths of the water. So you can read more about that to understand this progress that students in universities in China are looking to, are doing and exploring. And it's just a real sunshine amid all this drama that we are seeing as a global population with coronavirus. Mm-hmm. At least there's some young students somewhere trying to make the most of what they have and forge on with innovation, technology, and new discoveries.
Mm-hmm. Polly, thank you so much for watching the show. You just sent me a photo. Apparently, Jesus amechapaluku pale Jerusalem. Akingoja tu birthday yake. Come next week.
Okay, Sam.
Yeah.
Amechapaluku.
Amechapaluku pale Jerusalem. Akingoja birthday next week. So that's your way of saying Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas to you too, Polly. Okay. And thank you so much for watching Good Morning Kenya this Wednesday.
Absolutely. Yeah. And at that point, we just want to wrap up in the headlines, but we are not done with Good Morning Kenya. Let's have another quick look at the roads before we get to bring to you the day's discussions.
Good morning.
Now, before we continue with more of Good Morning Kenya, at exactly 8 a.m., time for our next traffic link. You're still focusing on what is happening along Juja Road in terms of traffic, so let's try and see if at all things have changed or it is the same situation as how it was, where it was just green all through, which means there's no traffic at all. But I've told you, I also told you earlier, rather, is that on this route, or better still on this road, there hasn't really been any ongoing road works, road activities. Simply, probably that's what we're seeing, especially in terms of traffic, where it's just green all through, meaning that there's no traffic moving at a pretty fast pace. So let's just begin from where the road starts. And this is at the Comarock roundabout as you leave Outer Ring Road. I had mentioned to you earlier that this specific road begins from there. It branches off from the major Outer Ring Road, just as how we have several other roads branching off from that specific route. And look at how things have changed, especially from the roundabouts. And this is on that section, just as you branch off to Juja Road, heading all over to the city center. A slight traffic buildup on that section as you head over to the CBD, but away from that, coming all through to the city center as you leave the estates, as you leave the areas of Outer Ring Road, coming all the way to the CBD on that section, green all through, meaning that there's no traffic moving at a really, really fast pace. So again, at least also as of now, we probably still do not have to look at any alternative routes because of what we are seeing, especially on the roads right now. And also what I'm seeing is that the beauty of actually this route right now is that it is green all through. So again, on this specific one, when I'm saying green all through, what I simply mean on this specific road is just that for as you leave the roundabout, coming all the way to the city center, and also as you leave CBD, as you leave the Pangani intersection, as you leave Thika Superhighway through that intersection, again coming all the way through Juja Road, as you head over to the other side of Outer Ring, and also still through Outer Ring as you head over to Thika Road. So that is what I mean when I'm saying on both sides, or better still on both lanes of this particular route. So that is where we're just spotting green all through, and this goes all the way till again next to Moi Forces Academy there. Again, that's also where we are beginning to spot a bit of traffic buildup, but that is on that lane that is leaving the intersection, leaving CBD, leaving Thika Road as you head over to the city center, which is quite interesting because it is on that lane where in this early morning hour you wouldn't expect to see any kind of traffic, but clearly as of now that is what we're spotting. But yes, in as much as this traffic, at least it is a manageable kind of traffic, and that is why we are seeing that orange color there. So again, anytime you see orange, it just means the traffic has begun to slightly build up, but it is a manageable kind of traffic. And again, also that goes all the way actually past that area. Again, green all through, meaning it's a smooth sailing, no traffic at all, moving at a really, really fast pace. So again, traffic begins to really heavy build up, just to really heavily build up before you get to the Mlango Kubwa roundabout. I had mentioned to you, in fact, the only ongoing works that have been spotted on this route or that have happened on this road is actually just, you know, that roundabout there. And that was put in place at least to ease the traffic flow there, but I'm not sure if that, you know, if it's serving its purpose in that regard, because clearly, as of now, just before you get to the roundabout, all through that entire section, heavy kind of traffic, and that's why we're seeing that red color there. So the red color is an indicator that traffic is really, you know, it's heavy kind of traffic moving at a very, very, very slow pace. And actually, that goes all the way before you branch off to the East Lee First Avenue. If you can't remember, again, that is another section where the Nairobi Metropolitan Services have really embarked on some roadworks, at least to make it easy for pedestrians on this at this particular section. This is at the Isili First Avenue. But away from that, again, just still sticking with Juja Road, moving at a really, really fast pace. As I mentioned to you, traffic just around the roundabout. This is at the Mlango Kubwa roundabout. But yes, as much as there's traffic there, at least it's not really that heavy kind of traffic. Also, this is one of those good alternative routes, especially for those coming from Juja Road, because again, it will lead you to the other side of Thika Road. So let's check if at all it can still serve its purpose in terms of being an alternative route. And yes, it can, because this is how it is looking like. Just as you leave the roundabout, traffic is only being spotted, or better still, being witnessed on that section there, just as you leave the roundabout, heading over before you enjoin to Thika Super Highway. But then again, also, it is a manageable kind of traffic. So for our viewers coming from the areas along Outer Ring, coming from the areas along Juja Road, you can use this as your alternative route, because past that route, before you get to Pangani, all there, before you get to the Pangani intersection, heavy kind of, in fact, on that section there, it is not moving at all, just at a standstill, and this is actually on both lanes. That's why I was giving you that alternative route there. This actually goes all the way before you get to the intersection there. But also I've mentioned to you that on this road, there hasn't really been any, you know, ongoing road works. We're still keeping tabs with most of these roads where either Kura or Kenha or even NMS are continuing with their ongoing road works, at least to make it easy for pedestrian, make it easy for those using either public or private vehicles. But at least as of now, this is how it is looking like in terms of traffic. Today, our focus was simply along Juja Road. But we are not yet done with Good Morning Kenya. There's still more of Good Morning Kenya after this short break. So stay with us. Welcome back to the program. I had mentioned to you that we are not yet done with Good Morning Kenya. It is time for our first conversation. We want to focus on matters, entrepreneurship and business, and at least to better understand more about the hospitality industry in this country. On set, I'm joined by Abigail Mkamburi, who describes herself as a business entrepreneur in matters hotel industry and matters hospitality in this country. Abigail. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you doing?
I'm fine.
Easy?
I'm easy. I'm okay.
Relaxed?
Yes.
And I'm fine too.
Oh, thank you.
Now, I've just mentioned that you are a business entrepreneur, but you see, you wear so many hats, and I'd love for you to just break it down for us, at least to better understand before we get deeper into hotel and industry, and also get deeper into what you do as a person when it comes to matters music. Who exactly is Abigail?
Okay, Abigail Mkamburi is a mom, and I'm also married. I'm a wife, and I'm a business woman, and also I'm a president. I do president worship as I'm a president worship minister. I minister in president worship in church, and also I've done some music. They are also in the YouTube. Yes.
So that's why I said you wear many hats.
Yes.
Because you're not just into business or just not into music or not just a mom, you're all of this encompassed together.
Yes.
So let's start from the business aspect. And I'd want to understand, why did you decide to join the hotel industry or hospitality industry as a whole? What was it for you?
Okay, for me, it was actually my husband is the one who had the passion and the vision to start a hospitality hotel, actually, because he had really traveled to so many countries and he has been in so many hotels, so he just loved the industry, and he started just having a vision. You want one day to own a hotel, yeah. So that's where the vision came from. So in the process, also as he was loving the idea, we were talking about it. I came to love the idea also. So from there, everything started rolling.
So clearly he was the vision bearer.
He is the vision bearer.
You just came into it.
Yes.
But you also, does it mean that you came into it just because you were the wife, or it's also something that you had loved, probably had passion for?
Of course, I've come also to love the hospitality industry. I've had an opportunity to go to some very nice hotels in and out of the country. So I love the industry. And in the process, I learned some few things here and there, housekeeping myself. I learned some of those things. So it wasn't so hard to start that business yet. That is not our career. But in the process, we learned so many things. So now we are running that hotel.
I love that you've mentioned that is not your career, both of you,
yes,
but you ventured into it.
Yes.
And you see, this also brings that aspect of sometimes you may be in a job space, but it may not necessarily be what your purpose is, because I want to believe that whatever especially you venture into in terms of business is also part of what you are created for. You know, it could be in whatever capacity or whatever front.
Yes.
Yeah. All right. Now, you're also talking to me. I mean, when you're talking earlier, you mentioned that you began in 2014.
Yes.
So it simply means that it's been 6 years down the line.
Yes.
How has it been being in that space or being in that business, the hotel business?
Okay. The first 2 years or 3 years, the business was not doing all that well because we had just started. Okay. So we had challenges of getting customers. But with time, we have been able to build up some customers. We were able to get some good sales here and there. So that kind of business, it can take even 10 to 15 years to break even. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so you have to be patient, and you should not give up. So we are very patient, but we have started seeing some good things coming out. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
When you're saying patience, it again opens a very big box, because it's always that issue, especially for us young people, that we always have all the time, that when you start something today, if it doesn't, then I feel like I'm not into it. Mm. So is it one of those things that we really lack a lot, especially when you get into business, and how can we avoid that?
You know, patience, actually, it's a virtue. Mm. It's a virtue. It's a virtue, and also in the Bible, it's the fruit of the Holy Spirit. Let me say that. But it's a virtue. So in business, you should not be in a hurry, because it can take a lot of years for you to break even. You have to be patient, and sometimes the sales can be low. So you have to come up with ways of juggling your business, how you'll get the cash flow, how you're going to pay salary and what have you. So people have to cultivate patience in doing business. When you're starting business, you must be patient. You have to be patient.
You have to be patient.
Yes.
So for you, you just mentioned that, you know, for the first 2 years, probably 2.5 years thereabout, the business was not doing good.
Yes.
But you still kept at it, because you're still on it right now, even 6 years later.
Yes,
so aside from that virtue of patience, and also for our viewers who probably want to get into business to better understand how to navigate that space, what also kept you tucked in? That you just want to, you know, in as much as it's not good as of now, but let me just keep on. Let us just keep on doing the business.
Okay, for me, I kept on believing that God is going to come through for the business.
Okay.
That is what actually kept the business going. I trusted and I believed that if God has brought us this far, we have done the hotel, it's finished, and we have started it. Actually, when we were starting the hotel, we didn't have rooms. We started with a restaurant only. And, you know, we were getting clients who were asking, where are the rooms? And we have not done any room. It's very expensive. And we are doing it very slowly, because you need a lot of cash flow. You need money to do the room. So it was just step by step. But the fact that I believe that God is going to enable us to come through and for us to be able to run the business. That is actually what kept the business going. Actually, it is the belief in God. That's what I can say.
It is the belief in God and the patience in it.
Yes.
So sometimes we tend to overlook these things, but, you know, it's just a matter of faith and a question of faith.
Yes.
Okay. So what exactly is your role in the business, since, you know, it's a business being done or being run by the two of you?
Actually, I'm the general manager. I do the general management of it. I manage the clients, sometimes the procurement, and so many other things. So I'm the general manager of the hotel. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Now, 6 years into that business, what would you say has been your most interesting part or interesting bit being in the hotel business?
Okay.
What stands out for you? Or what stood out for you?
Well, what do you mean? Let me ask.
In terms of, you know, like when you look at this, probably what happened or probably what has happened, you go like, wow, I love probably how we're making sales, I love how you're making profits, I love how clients are coming in. This is what is interesting for me, being in this particular business. So for you, what is it?
Okay, for me, the most interesting thing is that we have been training young people from lowly families, and people who are not able to get maybe to college, we have been giving them an opportunity to train. So we do something called in-house training. So the fact that we are able to train people to build a career, those who are not able to afford maybe to go to college, they cannot afford the basic education for hospitality industry or hotel and management. So we normally do some training. That has given me a lot of satisfaction, because we are able to build somebody from scratch. We have built actually a couple of young people from scratch. And from there, we have recommended them, we have given them a recommendation letter, and some of them, they are employed in big hotels in Mombasa. And we did training in the hotel, we did housekeeping training, we did restaurant training, and others we did in the kitchen. So we have been able to help the needy people. And that is what makes me to be satisfied and to be fulfilled and to stand out, yes.
So that's what makes it interesting for you to be
Yes. We are able to create somebody.
Okay. You see, now it makes sense.
Yes.
All right. Now, we'll be coming back to you in a bit. At least to probably expound that bit for us, how you go about in terms of picking who exactly, you know, are the needy persons. Because needy people are almost everywhere.
Yeah.
All right. So we want to take a very short breather. We are still speaking with Abigail. We'll continue this conversation of better understanding the hotel industry in this country after this break.
Moka
ni yako
hii nduti ni yangu hey. Niliwahi pale Quickbit Quickbit imekuja kusaidia wananchi kama sisi ndio yeah. Nilinunua 399 shillings juu nilikuwa the lowest unique bidder.
99 shillings.
Hey, Quickbit shilingi moja unaweza nunua
pia.
Shilingi mbili unaweza nunua micro.
Yeah.
Shilingi tano unaweza nunua hata gari.
So tupeleke huko hata.
Mtu aende huko.
Jiunga na Quickbit ni rahisi. Enda kwenye M-Pesa, bonyeza paybill kisha weka business number 4032353 kwenye account, weka kodi ya bidhaa unayotaka na bidii yako ya chini zaidi. Kwa mfano TV16, kisha weka shilingi 20 tu kama idadi yako. Weka bidii yako pia kwenye www.quickbit.co.ke. Kumbuka, bidii ya chini zaidi ya kipekee ndio ununua. Quickbit, bidhaa bora kwa bei ya chini.
Tonight on KBC Channel 1.
We have to run from here. Both of you go in that direction. Banti, Budeshwar and I shall go in the opposite direction.
Come on, move.
That boy will be sacrificed. And my dear brother will be hailed.
In order to lay a foundation of one's rule, if so many innocent people have been killed, then what is the point of such a ruler? And for how long will this series of murders and tortures go on?
Tonight on KBC Channel 1.
Where's your Mimi?
It is all over, Cobra. Good work. Arrest this bugger.
Who is this?
Hello?
Can I help you? Who is this?
I needed more time with him. More time.
Although this doesn't make it better, we are here for you. I am here for you. You will always be my son. You know that.
On the next episode of
Umevalia maridadi kweli kweli. Nasikiliza yako hii mvipi?
Sina shida tena.
Ha?
Shida zangu zote naziambia kwa heri.
Latifa, kwani umeshinda mamilioni?
Hii ni zaidi ya mamilioni nakwambia. Mpenzi wangu wa moyo, yoja kumchukua papa hapa. Twenda zetu ngambo. Sikiza. Mwambie Mr. Rocks niko hapa, aje nichukue.
Mimi hapa, Mr. Rocks. Mwenyewe.
Hivi nikawa nchanganya na changanyikiwa. Sikuelewi.
Usichanganyikiwe mwana.
Kikulacho jamani.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
And the drama begins.
You little rat, what the hell did you put my stock?
Ding dong.
I need a lawyer. You stupid monkey. I want my clothes back.
Oh, just shut up.
Sarah, where have you been?
In the Sakai, of course, sitting on the moon. Or what do you think?
Too bad you've got me, so make the best of it.
Shafu kishafu na supu ya nyama.
Iyo ni yeite.
Kamene?
Cassandra.
Ti palanta gaidan.
Omera satap.
That was my time, Farah Hersi.
Welcome back to the program. We still continue with our conversation. You're trying to better understand more about hotel industry and how just to go about starting that business for anyone who wants to venture into matters hotel or hospitality industry. I'm still in studio with Abigail Mkamburi. Now, Abby, you were speaking before we came on air about the trainings, how you go about sourcing your, you know, the people that you bring on board to train them. Yeah. I'd like you to better expound, you know, that for us, because we don't really see a lot of that in most of hotel industries. You know, just going out, picking people that do not or cannot afford to get these trainings, training them, even making sure they get jobs either there or somewhere else.
Okay, normally the people we normally get is the needy people and the orphans and the people who cannot afford to pay for the basic training.
So when you say the orphans and the needy, do you like go pick them from streets or is it a recommendation or how do you go about it?
Where we are based, there are some we have been getting some calls from the community. You know, there are villages there, and also there are elders from the villages. They know the needy children, they know the orphans, so they'll come and tell us, oh, we have this needy person, they need a training, can you really assist them? So that's where we get them from. Most of them, they are recommended by the village elders or somebody who just knows them. So we normally call them for an interview, we talk to them, and then we start profiling them. Then you can do the training, because there are some few things we look at before we give you training. There are some things we look at.
Okay.
Yeah, you have to be qualified in them. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So basically, like, what do you look at? What is it that makes it eat that you'll say, you know, for this one, I will pick this one, we'll put this one through a training program, which can help them probably later in life. What is it that you look at?
We look at many things. We look at teamwork,
okay,
integrity, discipline, hygiene, and also personal grooming. And also the ability for someone to be trainability. We look at those kind of things. Because you see, you can get someone who is maybe she's good in hygiene, but she is not trainable. So that we have to profile someone. Before we decide to train someone, we have to profile them. Then now we can do the training. There are some of them who can get maybe 3 out of 5 or 2 out of 5. So we try our best to see whether we can increase the threshold. Yeah.
Now, before we come to your music industry, I'd just like to know, so far, how many young people have you trained? And are you planning to expand your band?
Actually, there are many.
There are many.
I think there could be more than 30 since we started. Yeah. And others have been employed in other hotels in Mombasa. We do training and they get a better job, or maybe another hotel offers them better salary than us. And we tell them, if you're getting good money, go and work. Mm-hmm. Ours is to just try and empower them. Mm-hmm. So if there's we had another trainee who we trained for, she was there for a whole year. And she got a good job in Mombasa. I told her, don't leave the job, you go. So what I did, I just gave her a recommendation letter, and the hotel called me, and I told them, you have trained her in housekeeping, restaurant. We have trained also in conferencing and banqueting. So she's qualified, and she's employed there. She's getting good money. So the hotel was able to give her better salary than us, but we did the training. Mm-hmm. Yes.
And that's what you take pride in.
Yes.
Okay. Now, when we began the conversation, we mentioned that you are so many things. Aside from just the business, be it the mom, the wife, you're also into music.
Yes.
Let's talk about that a bit. Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
Okay. I'm a present worship minister. I also minister in present worship in church. So by the grace of God, I've been able to write music, and I've produced a couple of them. So even I have a new song actually called Unikumbuke. So also that is part of the thing that God has given me, and I really thank God for that. Yeah.
Before we go deeper into that, just for the minutes that we have left, I'd love to know, how do you juggle all this? Being a mom, big into business, being a wife, doing music.
It's a matter of planning, you know, actually. So because I'm
self-employed. The reason why I ask that question is because there's always this notion of, if you are a woman, you are a lady, you know, just stick to doing one thing. If you're a wife, just be a wife. If you are a mom, just be a mom. If you're into business, just do business. Like, there's always this notion that you cannot do all of these things at the same time, probably together. So when you talk about planning, What do you mean? How do you go about it?
Okay, the advantage I have is that I'm self-employed.
Okay.
So I'm able to plan. Like, I can say, this week I'm going to be dealing with my business. Okay. Next week I want to handle my music. Next week I want to take care of the children. Mm-hmm. Maybe there are stuff in school. So I just do planning. So it's a matter of the way you want to plan your time. Mm-hmm. You have to have a timetable of what you're going to do. You put your priorities first.
So just don't wake up and do whatever you want
to
do.
No, you cannot wake up today and say, I'm going to enter into a studio. No. And and maybe you have a client or you have a business meeting. So you have to have a schedule. You say, like, this week I'm dedicating this week for business only, and I'll do exactly business. Mm-hmm. And next week I'll say, next week I'm going to dedicate my time in studio, and I'm going to record my songs. I'll do a video. So I do a lot of planning. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because I'm doing so many things. I'm a mother, I'm a wife, and I'm a business person. And at the same time, I'm doing presentation, and I also sing every Sunday in church. Mm-hmm. We have to do some practices before the service starts. Yeah, so I have also to have time for that. Mm-hmm. So you have to, it's just plan your time.
So it's a question of planning and setting your priorities right,
yes.
Knowing what comes first as of now or at this point.
Yes.
Now let's go back to the music. So for you to get into music, why did you do that? Because, I mean, is it because you were just in praise and worship and you thought, okay, let me now start recording songs?
Actually, I was just doing praise and worship, and I was actually a backup singer. Mm-hmm. I wasn't even the solo singer. Mm-hmm. But what happened?
Nilikuwa uko nyuma,
I was backing up. Yani, that's what I used to do. And actually, what happened is that there's a time we were in church, and our apostle in church was told by God. Actually, said God has said, I told him, anoint these people, want them to start releasing songs. So we were anointed, and all of a sudden, I developed a gift of writing music. I was never born with that gift, but I developed the gift after receiving the anointing. So I started writing music, and here I could write and sing the music, I could get the rhythm. So the gift came upon me, and it was the will of God for me to do the music. Mm-hmm. So that's why I'm writing the song, and I'm doing the song. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a ministry that God gave me.
It's a ministry.
Yes.
So then what was your first song, and what bore that song?
My first song it's called Sifa. It was done in 2017. And actually, the song came as a result of God had delivered me from a very tragic accident, actually. There's one morning I was driving, I was taking my children to school, and I was in a very fatal accident, but by the grace of God, I never died. Mm. I was knocked by a lorry and a bus at the same time, so I was sandwiched in the middle.
You were knocked by a lorry and a bus at the same time?
Yes, actually, it was a horrible type of an accident. It was bad. But God, you know, God delivered me. I just told God, Jesus, have mercy on me. And God delivered me. I never lost even any part of my body, but the car was a wreck, total wreck.
And here you are not even, you know, disabled anywhere.
I am not disabled. So that is the grace of God. That is the goodness of God. And the song came from there, Sifa, that all the glory and honor goes to God because it is what he did for me. He delivered me from a very bad thing. And actually people are telling me, Mom, God loves you. You need to serve God because they saw what it was. There was a lot of traffic in Nairobi that day.
Just because of that, what happened?
Yeah, the traffic was so huge. You know, now the car was there.
Yeah.
Kumefungana everywhere. Uh-huh. So the situation was bad, but God delivered me. So I have a reason to thank God also.
Clearly you do, because yeah. I'm imagining just being sandwiched between a bus?
And a lorry. And those are two big things, and they're knocking you, and you're in the middle.
Ah.
So what helped me, somehow the car went off from the road. Mm-hmm. So it was a total wreck, but I came out. I never lost any blood. Mm-hmm. I never lost even a single tooth. That is God at work.
Clearly it is.
It is God at work.
Well, it looks, just thinking about it, feels like it's really traumatizing.
Very bad.
And it
actually,
was.
It took, I was traumatized, by the way, mm-hmm. but God delivered me
God
out of
delivered
it.
God delivered you.
Yeah, thank God.
So that is what bore you first.
That song,
Sifa Zote.
Sifa Zote.
Yeah. And from then on, you've just been writing and recording music.
Yes.
So that means you write your own music also.
I write all the music,
mm-hmm.
my own music.
So that, now, does that mean that every song you release, it's a different inspiration?
Yes.
Okay.
It depends. Sometimes you can be in a circumstance, or rather, or the Lord can give you inspiration. Mm-hmm. He can give you a song. Mm. It depends.
It depends.
Yeah.
All right. Now, I'd like to talk about that bit of writing songs, because oftentimes they say, especially in this kind of industry, they would say that someone will be gifted in singing, you know, the vocal bit.
Mm-hmm.
There's another person who's gifted in writing.
Mm-hmm.
So why wouldn't they emerge? Because there's always that tendency of, I want to do everything by myself. It's my craft. It's my thing. So do you feel like someone who's in that space, or in this kind of industry, that we need to get to that point whereby you just identify what your gift is, and you can allow someone to even write for you, and you come sing, so that you don't have all it all together, and you probably cannot do one thing?
You see, it depends how God has gifted you.
Mm.
Some people, they're not able to write the music.
And but they can sing very well.
But they can sing very well. And others can write and they cannot sing. There are those people in that category. Mm-hmm. But there are others who can write and sing it at the same time.
Mm.
So it just depends how God has given. Because these things, they come from God.
Mm.
Nobody can say that the voice belongs to them.
Mm.
The voice you have, the gifting belongs to God.
Mm-hmm.
So it is God who chooses what to give you. So you work with what God gave you. If you can't write the music, you get someone to write for you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So if you can't write, get someone to write for
yeah,
you.
Yeah, you can sing, but some people, they're good at even singing other people's songs.
Yeah.
But they can't write their own music.
They
so
can't.
It depends with how God has really gifted you.
Mm-hmm.
It's about God. Yes.
So it's all a question of identify where exactly you're strong at.
Yes.
Identify what exactly your gift is.
Yes.
If it's probably, you know, writing, just stick to it. If it's singing, just stick to it. If it's both,
you do.
Why not?
Yeah. And if you can write also for other people, people they do write for. I've not written any song for anyone,
mm-hmm.
but there are people who write songs for other people. You
mm-hmm.
can also write for other people, they can sing.
Mm-hmm.
But I tend to think when you're a praise and worship minister,
mm-hmm.
I'm saying praise and worship artist,
mm-hmm.
those are two different things.
Yeah.
When you're a praise and worship minister, you need to spend a lot of time with God.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Now, you've brought something that I want to ask, which I was trying to avoid that question, because
mm-hmm.
it just into lifestyle right now, but that bit of minister and artist. Now, since you've mentioned it,
mm-hmm.
I'd like to pick your mind on that, because it's always a question I tend to ask all the time, anytime we have this conversation, especially with gospel ministers or gospel artists, regardless of how they want to call themselves. And every person always has... how would I put it? Every person has an individual explanation of how they want to describe what for them is a gospel minister and what for them is an artist, or what for them is a minister and what for them is an artist. And now you've just mentioned there's a difference between the two.
Yeah, there is.
So I'd love to pick your mind in regards to that. What for you is a minister and what for you is an artist?
Okay, a minister is someone who is being inspired by the Holy Spirit.
Mm. And that is a minister.
Yeah, that's a minister. And your music.
So now you are a minister.
I'm a minister. I cannot wake up just anyhow and write music.
Mm-hmm.
It comes from the inspiration. And maybe I've spent a lot of time, maybe I've been fasting and praying. Then you get the music there. Or rather, maybe you're waiting upon the Lord and the music comes.
Mm-hmm.
But for gospel artists, they're gospel entertainment. They can release they're mentioning God here and there,
mm-hmm.
but they're entertaining at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
So it's those kind of people, they don't have to spend a lot of time praying and fasting, and they can just write any song, release it, and you can see the dancing moves and the way they're doing everything in it, you know this is gospel entertainment. But for gospel ministration, it is so much about God and about the way you are dealing with God. It's about the intimate relationship you have with the Holy Spirit. And you'll find most of the time you'll be singing praise and worship. For gospel ministers, it is praise and worship. For the other gospel artists, it's any kind of
entertainment. That's why we have so many other genres that we call. We probably have the hip hop gospel, Afro gospel, yes. All of that.
And you see, like for gospel artists, their songs, they don't deal with your spirit. Even if you listen to that kind of song, it doesn't cut your heart.
Inakubamba tu,
but it doesn't minister to you. But there's a song, praise and worship, you can listen to it. It's really ministering to you. You feel like you're being convicted. Like you're remembering the sins you have committed. You start repenting. You understand?
Now that's for gospel ministry.
That's a ministry. Okay. And also maybe you've been sick, there's a song you can hear, you get healed all of a sudden, you realize I am healed. Mm-hmm. Or rather you get delivered from maybe a depression or oppression of some kind. Mm-hmm. That is ministration. And also ministration is you are ministering to God. Mm-hmm. Because the word of God says that those who worship God shall worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. Mm-hmm. You understand? Mm-hmm. But for gospel entertainment, you enjoy.
Feel good,
feel nice. But by the end of the day, you're still the same person. Your spirit has not been ministered to. Those are two different things.
So now actually there is a difference.
There's a big difference.
Now, since you're calling yourself a gospel minister, have you had instances, or you're calling yourself a minister, have you had instances where someone has told you, you know, from all your seven songs, because you at least have seven of them as of now, that probably I've listened to this one and it has turned my mind around, it has changed my life, I was sick on this place and now I'm feeling better, or I was going through this and now I'm good?
Actually, there are some people, I normally receive messages from the DM and Facebook. Mm. There are some people who have been listening to my songs, and actually they are born again. They got born again. They gave their life to Christ themselves.
And at this point, they don't even know you, they're just listening to
your
song.
No, they told me, Mom, I was listening to your song, I've decided to give my life to Christ. Mm-hmm. I was going down spiritually, now I am restored, I'm revived. That is ministry. The song, I wasn't there to pray for them, but the song is ministering to them. Why? Because the power of God and the Spirit of God is in the song. So the power of God is ministering to their spirit. You don't even have to pray for them. The Spirit of God himself is busy ministering to them. So them, they are just writing to you, this song is ministering to me. There's also another person who was telling me, I don't like listening to your song. I feel like God is coming too close to me. I want to enjoy my life. You understand? So they feel like
this is how much deep it is.
It is deep because it is the Spirit actually ministering. It's the Spirit in the song, the Spirit behind the song. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Wow. Now, as you bring the conversation to a close, Abigail, and just at least again to bring to our viewers why we were having also the convo about you being ministers, because you wear so many hats. And we began by saying you're a mom, you're a wife, you're into business, you're into music. And I just want you to speak to ladies out there. This is for those I probably think, I can only do one thing. I can't do all of these things. I probably like what you are doing. Finally, as we bring it to a close, what would you tell them?
For me, I'll tell the ladies just to ask for the grace of God, because it is it's God who gives you the grace.
Okay.
Whatever I do, and there's so many hats I'm wearing, I can say it's not by my own strength, mm-hmm. but it's by the grace of God. Mm-hmm. So if you want to be able to do so many things at the same time, please ask for God to give you grace and empower you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Grace and empower.
Yes.
All right. That was Abigail Mkamburi, an entrepreneur in Matters Hotel, a mom, a wife. She's also into music. That's why we're having all this, you know, entire conversation. And that's actually where we bring it to a close this mm-hmm. morning. But good morning, Kenya is not yet done. We still have more of what is on the show after this very short break, so stay with us.
Moka
ni yako
hii nduthi ni yangu niliwahi pale Quickbit Quickbit imekuja kusaidia wananchi kama sisi ndio nilinunua 399 shillings juu nilikuwa the lowest unique bidder
300
$199.
Eh, quick bit shilingi moja unaweza nunua pia. Shilingi mbili unaweza nunua microwave. Shilingi tano unaweza nunua hata gari.
Sio tupeleke huko hata.
Mtu aende huko.
Jiunga na quick bit ni rahisi. Enda kwenye M-Pesa, bonyeza paybill kisha weka business number 4032353. Kwenye account weka kodi ya bidhaa unayotaka na bidii yako ya chini zaidi. Kwa mfano TV16. Kisha weka shilingi 20 tu kama idadi yako. Weka bidii yako pia kwenye www.quickbit.co.ke. Kumbuka, bidii ya chini zaidi ya kipekee ndio ununua. Quickbit, bidhaa bora kwa bei ya chini.
A love from the past will mark the love from today.
I love you, Mauro. I love you like I have never loved before.
Now the same obsession that ruined the past will try to destroy the present. Only this time, love will have more than one obstacle ahead.
I need a doctor to tend to her right away. Please, miss. A doctor. Call a doctor.
Loving you is all I want.
Welcome back to Good Morning Kenya. My name is Jen Wamboi, and we are just from such a powerful discussion. Doreen, man.
Damn.
Being hit by a lorry and a bus at the same time.
Na uko hapo katikati.
Oof. For those who are wondering, maybe Doreen, you could brief our viewers who have just joined us in regards to what we are talking about.
Yeah, we're just having a conversation with Abigail, who is into business. She's a musician. Mm-hmm. And when we actually got that music bit of it, she was explaining to us that her first song, Sifa, was as a result of what she went through. She got into an accident and she was sandwiched. Alikuwa hapo katikati, lori na basi.
Is it sandwich or Oreo?
Ni hata ile utataka kuita tu.
Alikuwa tu hapo katikati.
But you see, I think what has stood out for me in that story is that after all of that, imagine ata haku lose meno, hakuna kitu ilitoka. The blood that came out was not even a lot, and she was not even disabled. You know, ulikuwa katikati hizi gari kubwa kubwa.
Can you imagine?
Chances are, ata ukitoka hapo alive, either utakuwa na some form of disability. Utakuwa deformed. But for her, imagine she's well.
We thank God for her life.
God.
We thank God for her life. And these things happen, by the way. But when you get out of them, if you're given a testimony, testify.
Yeah.
That's usually what I say. Don't, if a testimony is given, don't keep it to yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Testify, manze. Watch out to ajue Mungu yuko.
God name so.
Yeah. So we've been having a show where in the morning we discussed issues to do with colorism. Manzeo story many letter feedback.
What are people saying?
People are saying that they've been going through issues right here. Streets been unkind to them. You remember those areas we said that people can actually afadhali nyumba ikaivo lakini iskodishwe Mwafrika. Yeah, people are actually opening up, and I don't want to read some of those messages on national television because some of them are quite personal.
The experiences that they have gone through.
They even go ahead and mention names.
Of the places.
Of the places and the people.
That we will not mention, but
so
we know.
We cannot mention that, but we appreciate your contribution to the show, and we feel you, Manze. Pole sana. You know, there's nothing as bad as someone discriminating you over something you have no control over.
Exactly. Mm.
And to make it worse, it is somebody who, by virtue of them being here, I'm trying to choose my words very carefully.
No, I mean,
to say what I'm about to say on national television. You find that the people who are projecting this colorism onto you, this is not their motherland, their birthland.
That is the worst part.
Yeah.
That is the saddest part. You know? And the way they do it is like they are in their own space, yet they are in yours.
Mm. Others are even talking about the treatment they get in shops where they're employed. And the fact that, you know, they're discriminated against just because of their skin color. And they're made to believe that they're inferior. They're less of human beings, and they never rise to the occasion. They will never be given an opportunity to do that. Because at the end of the day, know your place.
Yeah.
Poleni sana.
You even remember the incident that was, I don't know if it was this year or last year, of that employer who was caning his employee who came in late.
I remember.
Mm-hmm.
It was last year.
It was last year?
Was it last year?
Racism was, of course,
it was
involved.
Early this year.
Colorism, all those forms of ism.
All those had a role to play
now,
there.
Because there was a restaurant, in fact, it was way even before COVID.
Mm.
So a friend of mine, we went for some meal at some restaurant. And I won't mention the restaurant. But can I tell you something?
Mm-hmm.
As soon as we stood to walk out, those seats were thoroughly cleaned.
Wow, really?
Yeah. Ile unasema ati wache ufike lu alafu toke. Nilipata mtu amesugua hizo viti.
And someone does it on your face.
Yeah,
like they don't even care how you feel or how you take
you
it or
tell,
how it will affect you.
You could tell our presence there has just made them uncomfortable. Kabisa.
You see, even as you talk about
so,
this.
So I wondered, zile vitu tumetumia vijiko sahani zitatupwa? Ama what's happening?
Because kama kiti inaweza kuwa clean that way, ni kama inakuwa sanitized. Ni kama umekuja na ugonjwa fulani.
And this was way before COVID.
What about the cutlery?
Na venye tulikuwa tumengara.
But do you think this is something that is ingrained in so many people? Because even when, what we see on TV, when people see people of lighter skin tones and mostly white people, they get wananza kuangaliangalia, having those two random mamas, you know. There's this excitement that you get to see from people when they see people of lighter skin tones, fairer skin tones. Is it something that people are, it's so deeply rooted, so deeply seated that sometimes you do it without even realizing it.
Mm-hmm.
Is it, could that be the problem?
It's part of the
it's
problem.
It's part of the problem.
It's part of the problem because it's called enculturation.
Mm.
Once you embrace a certain traits, a certain behavior
certain
in a bid to
thinking.
Uphold a certain culture, that is part of the problem. And the thing is, as we keep saying here, you are a person by your own right.
Yeah.
You are an entity by right, by virtue of the fact that you're a human being.
Mm-hmm.
And no one should ever castigate you over that. It doesn't matter how you look. It doesn't matter what deficiency you've got. It doesn't matter what issue you're dealing with. You're human. You're good. You're beautiful. You're intelligent. You're important. And you've got your role to play in life. So never allow anyone to sort of get in the way of all that. Because it's really not fair.
Yeah, but I feel like we've just given a lot of prominence to light, you know, lighter skin. And you see the way we're even saying here in this country, you'll get even to some job spaces that unless you're light, you probably
unless
wouldn't be getting
a
that job.
Way.
Yeah, and actually, it has to be light in a certain way. Mm-hmm. And you see, even as you talk about this bleaching thing, and yes, we know it is wrong because there are also some health implications that come with it. But sometimes it just, and we can never justify it because, as we are mentioning, probably is wrong. But you see, it also stems from what the society upholds as what is good. Because just the way we are saying, there's some jobs you can't get unless you are light, unless you look a certain way, and it's some certain form of light, you know, some certain form of lightness. So ultimately, this makes someone to feel, what can I do to just be that person, to be able to get this job, to be able to stay in that place, to be able to walk into some certain spaces? Because then again, also, there's some places you can walk into. Kama haukai hivyo vile hawa watu wanakaa, it feels like you are out of space, out of place, na uko in your own country.
This reminds me of another video I came across yesterday. This couple, interracial couple, a Malawian lady married to a Caucasian man. And when you look at the video she has posted, she has been teaching her husband about her culture. And he has been so open to it, especially carrying a baby with a leso. You know, that is such
the
an African
now.
Thing. Yes. As Africans, kubeba mtoto na leso, unameka kwa mgongo, yufunga with a leso. It's such an African thing. So she was teaching her husband how to do this by himself so that he can be helping her with the kids. But then somebody went onto her comments, a fellow Malawian, and accused her of being a race traitor.
What?
Yes.
A what?
A race traitor.
What's a race traitor? What's that? That's English for?
Malawi.
Culture, traitor.
Oh.
By virtue of just her
like
teaching
violating?
Her husband. Yes, now that's what...
So that is what it means, like she was violating the African
yes,
culture
like
by
you
teaching
are, yeah.
someone who's not African, the African things.
Yes, like you are a betrayer of the
what
African
is wrong
culture.
With that?
You know, and the African race, Ati, you are a race traitor by virtue of just trying to teach her husband, mind you, how to carry a baby, how they do it back home. And I'm like, when will this end, man?
But there's so many things that we can sit here and talk about when it comes to accepting people and who they are. Mm-hmm. And the variety is quite wide. We can start talking about A, B, C, D. At the end of the day, be kind, extend, be warm. Always be that person who provides that comic relief.
The warmth,
okay? Yeah, the
literally.
Warmth, Manze. The world is already too harsh. We're dealing with a pandemic. The economy is going down. I mean, people are losing jobs. You do not need to become one more problem.
Yeah.
Okay, become a pocket of sunshine, as I would call them. Yeah?
Absolutely, man.
But coming up next, we've got a sitting, a special sitting in the Senate, where Mike Mbuvi Sonko's fate will begin to be... I don't want to say analyzed, but...
looked into.
Looked into. That's the word I was looking for. Looked into. So KBC Channel 1 will be live, and we shall be bringing you those proceedings right here, and we'll be telling you exactly what will be transpiring from the Senate today. It's happening today and tomorrow, ladies?
Yes.
Yeah,
the
so.
Final decision will come in tomorrow, but of course the sittings are happening between today and tomorrow. The live proceedings, of course, will be coming in our subsequent programming. As and when the signal gets here, we'll be sure to keep you up to date with that. So, and of course, people have been saying so much about this Sonko issue on social media, and the big question is whether he will survive. And the opinion on social media is divided right at the center, from what I'm seeing, at least. So many people saying that this will not, this impeachment will not stand, and a greater majority also saying that this is the end of the road for Mike Sonko.
It is
Mike
what it
Sonko.
Is.
He gets to know his fate.
Unajua kuna vitu mingi sana najua tunafungia ndani kuhusu
history.
Mi hata sitaki tuongee. In fact, I'm
so
redrawn into
it's
the
like,
conversation.
It's like, yeah, we are just
it's
dropping,
a trend, by the way. You
something.
Can check it out on Twitter.
Yeah, you check it out on Twitter and see the amount of bile that people are expressing online. But bado nimekwama kwa ile nini ya Polly, by the way. Rokumbuka? Jane?
Gani?
The one of Jesus amechapaluku pale Jerusalem akingoja birthday next week.
I think it's funnier.
Yeah.
When you read it in Swahili.
Exactly. So amechapatu luku pale Jerusalem anangoja birthday yake next week.
He come.
Yeah, manze come through. Yeah.
Anasababisha kivyake.
Exactly. So anasababisha kivyake. But also there's a quote from Mahatma Gandhi that first they ignore you, then they laugh at you, then they fight you, then you win.
Then they
want to
be you.
Then they want to be you.
Tuongeze
you up. Yes, sasa meant to party a version yetu. Mm-hmm. Then they want to be you.
But they can't.
But they can't, you know? Because anyone who tries to be you is average.
And is fake.
Is fake.
Because you is you.
Is me.
Allah.
Is me, you.
But then we're trying to...
Is you, me.
Kwani kuna story, nenele hapa na sijui.
Kwani, is there you? Is you there?
Is you there?
Is we me?
Yeah.
I was asking you what you want to chapo siku ya Christmas. Rice of wheat flour, used as a major ingredient in such foods as chapo, bread, and cakes, shot by 18%. So Christmas will not be as that good.
They've shot up by 18%?
Yes, sir.
But I kind of expected it to happen.
You did?
Yes.
And this comes at a time when prices of food are really, you know, going up.
Actually, there's
every prices are going up everywhere.
There's a warning
everywhere.
On inflation, and yeah. That means that the cost of living is going to go high, mm-hmm. especially next year. And there's a looming drought, okay, that is expected to come early
and
next year.
And there's a second wave.
A second wave of locust invasion. Thank you, Doreen.
Thank you so much for finishing it. Because where?
So, unacheki ile kamiti tulituma ituangalilia 2021 venye inaka wamerudi manze.
Na wamesha ambia venye itaka. Wameambia story ya food, wameambia story ya locust. Wameambia pia vile taxes inarudi juu. It is what it is.
But we're not scaring you. Look forward to 2021. We're just informing you. These are issues that have been laid bare for you to consume. Whatever you choose to do with that information is entirely up to you, Manzi. All we do is let you know. What you choose to do with that info
is up to you.
Kwa raha zako, Manzi.
Kidney bado ni 52 million.
Kwa raha zako. Yeah, by the way, kidney inaenda for 52 million. Whatever you choose to do with that information, again, is entirely up to you.
If you choose, you wanna.
If you wanna. It didn't come from us. You know what I'm saying?
If you choose, you don't wanna do anything about.
Then don't wanna do anything about what we just don't wanna say. Yeah, but what do you choose to do with that information?
If you choose to understand what just happened here, you know, it's just you choosing to get it.
Yeah. So next week, we shall be decorating our Christmas tree, ladies.
Yes.
Looking forward to that.
Yeah. It's already here.
It's already here. So we shall be engaging you in the process of actually forming it up and putting up Santa.
And we shall also be looking all Christmas. Christmas-ish.
Yeah. Is it the 21st or the 23rd?
Christmas-y. Doreen, no, we will not get over that. You cannot say where.
Kuna vile yu mda we mekata.
And Christmas issue.
Dorin fanya hivi, we wind up to watch na Jane.
Tutokumalizia. Unamuk.
Na hivi aza.
Okay, I know I used that wrongly, but.
Yes, you did. You actually did.
All right, guys.
As a director, amesha niliberate.
Amekurap.
Like, we need to wind up the show. And thank you so much for coming through and for joining us for Good Morning Kenya this Wednesday. Mm-hmm. My name is Samuel Njoroge. Asante ni sana kwa kuja. I mean, thank you so much for coming. Enjoy the rest of your day. Good morning. Oh, she's Jane and Doreen. I also thought I should throw that in there. Sawa basi. Thank you so much.
Cha Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala watapata bishara njema kwenye dunia na akhira.
Niwe pweke moyoni fifuadi. Niwe hobi.
On the next episode of
Umevalia maridadi kwa kweli. Nasikilida yako hii mvipi wewe?
Sina shida tena.
Ha?
Shida zangu zote naziambia kwa heri. Latifa, kwani umeshinda mamilioni?
Hii ni zaidi ya mamilioni nakwambia. Mpenzi wangu wa moyo, yuaja kumchukua papa hapa. Twenda zetu ngambo. Sikiza. Mwambie Mr. Rox niko hapa, aje nichukue.
Mimi hapa Mr. Rocks mwenyewe.
Even nikawa nchanganya na changanyikiwa. Sikuelewi.
Usichanganyikiwe mwana.
Kikulacho jamani.
Tonight on KBC Channel 1.
We have to run from here. Both of you go in that direction. Banti, Budeshwar and I shall go in the opposite direction.
Come on, move.
That boy will be sacrificed. And my dear brother will be hailed.
In order to lay a foundation of one's rule, if so many innocent people have been killed, then what is the point of such a ruler? And for how long will this series of murders and tortures go on?
Tonight on KBC Channel 1.
Where's your Mimi?
It is all over, Cobra. Good work. Arrest this bugger.
Who is this?
Hello?
Can I help you? Who is this?
I needed more time with him. More time.
Although this doesn't make it better, we are here for you. I am here for you. You will always be my son. You know that.
Tonight on KBC Channel 1.
Baby, when the bright lights start to fade, fire up your lighter, count on with the wave.
I love my girl to some reggae. It's been a long day. Taxi driver wants to talk me here like me no know about choir.
Everybody wanna be like me, forget your troubles.
On the next episode of
Umevalia maridadi kwa kweli. Na sikilida yako hii mvipi wewe?
Sina shida tena.
Ha?
Shida zangu zote naziambia kwa heri.
Latifa, kwani umeshinda mamilioni?
Hii ni zaidi ya mamilioni nakwambia. Mpenzi wangu wa moyo, yoja kumchukua papa hapa. Twende zetu ngambo. Sikiza. Mwambie Mr. Rocks niko hapa, aje anichukue.
Mimi hapa Mr. Rocks mwenyewe.
Even nikawa nchanganya na changanyikiwa. Sikuelewi.
Usichanganyikiwe mwana.
Kikulacho jamani.
Close the session and then resume with the reading of the charges on the proposed removal from office by impeachment of Honorable Mike Mbuvi Sonko, the governor for Nairobi County. That will be followed by hearing as well as determination of the proposed removal from office by impeachment of